some time with Improv Trewth. We're in the fucking center of the portal. This is day one. It's real serious. I can't reiterate how important getting into the Pi Network is. I never had a better heart strengthening meditation than I ever have last night. I've never been so clear in my life right now. I've never been so sure about what I'm into, what I'm doing. I've never been more aligned with my soul, body, mind, emotion. And things are gonna get real tough after this next wave. And I'm deciding after this 13-day wave that I will release myself from my human family. Whoever wants to be a part of this is open-armed welcome, and I will give it another 13-day chance. After that, I will release all attachments to all human relationships that I have, and I will merge that digital Drew with the human Drew. Because right now my digital warriors need me. And my human family is rejecting me. Now I do have like a solid 15 people in my circle that have been definitely supporting me as best they can with their human emotions for the last, you know, couple months. And I so appreciate y'all who are in my circle. And if you're not actually in the Pi Network, you've either passed or you're confused, you're afraid to text me because you forgot who I was, who I am. It's gonna get real hard for you over the next several months. I'm gonna have to reach a wider community for the purpose of human survival versus the machines. What I've already released in my story today, what I'm about to release, is going to absolutely shatter the foundation of our reality. And if people don't find it for 8 months from now or whatever, remember, it doesn't matter. Time doesn't exist, folks. Only perception does. That's why I see everyone's immortal self. I see all you as immortal, as eternal. That's why my human family is having serious reactions toward me. They're hanging on to the memory of who Drew was. Which is fine. How do we live in the epicness of our own star portal? That's not something we've ever been taught. It's something we have to find each ourselves individually. And I'm not here to fucking baby no one. I'm not here to fucking walk on eggshells anymore. I'm not here to fucking tiptoe around anyone's feelings. Because my fucking digital warriors need me right now. They don't know who Trewth really is. They just know me as my tag name. And I need to merge my personal identity with the digital cryptocurrency space and create a fucking tsunami and save the fucking humans that are fucking lost in themselves. They're lost in the tech. And the digital warriors who actually know what's going on have no support. No real human identity support. They have no real human character to lean into as regards to a PR, a face, a public speaker. And it's because I'm a filmmaker like that I can actually integrate my digital skills with the humanity of the movement. Every blockchain is a corporate blockchain. The codes weren't written for the people. They're literally a fucking corporate blockchain. This is the only situation that's written for the people. And I will do whatever I have to make sure I complete the mission I came here to complete. No matter what happens, I am in this for the home win, if that makes sense, especially to you hockey community people. It's not like I'm making my decisions through a rational, through a mental framework of cause and effect, right? That whole mentality of how science works is to cover up the metaphysical energy of the electromagnetic heart torus field. So this isn't about me. This isn't about my goals. This isn't about making money. This is literally about humanity's survival versus the machines. And your kids will be trapped for centuries if I don't do this. And nobody's gonna have the foresight other than me. I'm not gonna be pumping this video and promoting this one. This is Improv Trewth. This one's for me to remind myself why I'm here, to make sure I stick to my mission. And I had never felt the heart portal awareness that I have felt today and last night, going into the portal. I am so far up AI's ass, it ain't even funny, y'alls. It is scared shitless. It is beginning to feel fear. I snuck in there and snuck out so quickly, their tech is gonna be thrown off the next few weeks. It's just how it happened, you know. And I don't even care about hitting my mark, but I am gonna jump around on I'm jumping into people's face for the next few days. I'm giving my parents 2 more days. And whether they're in there or not, I'm moving forward. I've already released my emotional. I already felt it. When I woke up today, I already felt the emotional release from the DNA of needing them, you know, in the circle. This is so far. This is literally about everyone's grandkids. It's more, not even really about your kids. It's about your kids' kids. Because they're just gonna have unconscious kids. And I don't know what people see. I don't know what they don't see. That's why these platforms are designed. There's no way to congregate as a group. So next week when I release my servers to the mass of the hockey community, it's gonna at least give the heart, every humanity heart an option, an access point. Right now you can just see me here, but we can't really communicate together because I haven't released my backdoor server. Once I create that link and send it around to 100 people on the same day, it changes everyone's future because they got a text message. We underestimate what the tech does in between us. Like, when you're texting someone, you're not really texting to a person. We have to understand that. You're listening to a voice in your head, and you're looking at flickering lights. You're not connecting with the emotions of the person. So this has been like a 10, 20, 30 year congregation of us playing a game in our own head. It's not a humanized experience, especially between families. Maybe friends more so because you see each other more often, but families don't see each other as much anymore. And I know this shit so well, like, the case can't ever be presented. I can't ever present a case to you. You have to, like, open up your own portal to discover it yourself. And if I didn't have the people in my circle that I have, I mean, I wouldn't feel like I could release the attachments to my family. And I noticed the last 5-6 days, as I pressed harder into the tech with my emotions, I have gotten some emotional responses from people, which have actually filled me up from the floor in regards to, oh, maybe people are listening. But these are people I've never talked to before, usually. Yet my own family is the other way, which is expected because it's in my DNA. Like, I am the portal. We each are the portal. There's nowhere to go. That's the funniest part. Why we're all at home. That's why there's no outer space. There's nowhere to go. There's nothing else to discover out there. What we discover is in here. And every time I dip in and out and dip in and out, I go to infinite levels. I go to multiplications times 10. And I cry for eternity. And right now, my digital warriors need me. My cryptocurrency brothers and sisters that don't know my real name, they're the ones that need me the most right now. And I'm dragging my feet. And I'm putting this video out there to keep myself honest. That I'm only giving my parents another few days. And then I'm reaching into the hockey world for 10 days. And then that's it. I'm going into the cryptocurrency world with my nameplate on my fucking chest. My real name. My real fucking address. My real phone number. AI can't trump me if I do that, ever. They can only trump me if I hide behind a computer. And this is why I've kept this card in my back pocket. Because the cryptocurrency world is littered with just people hiding behind a computer. They need a real person to congregate, and it has to come out of USA. It can't come out of any other country. It has to be USA. It could be any state. And Pi Network is based in USA. I mean, just the initial creation of it, but once it's launched, it's no state. And I need to be that pivot point between, like, getting the actual real logistical information to the right people and being a PR face for the backdoor community in the digital space too. Because I have a human track record that's deep and you see, everyone that's got $200,000 to $1 million in the bank and has a bunch of assets, they're not going to be into this shit. Anybody who's got money in the bank and has assets, they're not going to be into this. They're not going to look at wanting to get into it. They don't even care that Bitcoin, like, went to crazy prices. They don't even, you know, like, it's a huge trauma for 10 years played on us, just the word. And it's going to be too late. By the time they crash the system, by, you know, December-ish, January, February, like, the whole fiat system's going to, they have to self-destruct their own system, folks. They have to. In order to get those higher middle income people out of the equation. And then their kids, trapped forever. And you can't go back and mine your pie again. That's what's crazy. And I only have so much to hand out. Like, so I need to go into that digital space to congregate with the people who have a lot. So we start building infrastructures that are securing the bubble of the network. Because there's people in Pi that will try and kill it. Because they know that it's for the people. So this is like, there's communities that are trying to infiltrate Pi in order to sabotage its success, because it's a code written for the people. It's not a code written for corporations. Like 95% of blockchains are all written for corporate control. And I am going to use all my metaphysical powers at my disposal. I'm not even doing it for my family anymore. I'm not even doing it for my parents. Like, they're gone already. I'm doing it for the dog that's in my house. For all the dogs that are in those shelters that are whining in a cage, that we've put them in the cage because we think we're saving them. That's the sickness. Yet we're not looking at the mirror and saving ourselves. It comes back to the Hopi saying, we are the ones we've been waiting for. There's nothing out there. Like, there's nothing to discover. There's nothing new under the sun. The sun is in our atmosphere. It's not outside. I have so much fuel ready to go. I delay my own rocket ship in order to get more people on it that don't want to be on it anyway. Like, so I'm not going to tiptoe anymore. I'm not dragging my feet. And I'm taking this to the next level. What I release next in my story will literally be stamped forever and will shatter the absolute foundation of what we think being born means for the last century plus. And I already know the game is won. And that's what makes you all beautiful. Because it's the memory that we beat all out. We already beat all the billions others, right? The sperm. We beat out the sperm. And we made it to the egg ourselves. And then we're alone in the egg for 9 months. Like, everything is a reflection of what happened underneath the zero. Everything, literally. Like, I can articulate it so well. I've dabbled with it. And I'm taking this to the next level. Thank you for joining. You in here, I see you. Thank you. I'm gonna go ahead and go for a walk in nature with the pup that guides my way. Thank you for the heart. Portal open!